Greetings, junior scientists, scientists, and citizens of this big, weird, wild, and wonderful world in which we live. As always, I'm your humble science communicator, the Great Orbax, coming to you here from the Department of Physics at the University of Guelph. And I'd like to welcome you to December's Stargazing Guide. As winter sets in, it's sometimes difficult to get a good, clear view of the night sky. But that doesn't mean that there still isn't plenty happening up there. If you manage to avoid the usual December cloud cover, there are some incredible constellations visible. Starting out in the east, Orion continues his celestial battle with Taurus the Bull throughout early winter. Within Taurus, you should be able to see the Pleiades star cluster. First observed through a telescope by Galileo Galilei, this star cluster contains over 800 stars, but most of those are too dim to be seen with the unaided eye. But it does contain 9 very bright stars, which you should be able to see. So get out there and see if you can count them all. There are a few planets from within our very own solar system that are visible this month. The largest planet in our solar system, Jupiter, along with the ringed Titan Saturn, should continue to shine brightly as they have throughout the autumn. As a matter of fact, if you happen to have a telescope, you should actually be able to see the rings around Saturn, as well as Titan, the largest of Saturn's 82 moons. As you look towards the southwest horizon, you should be able to catch Venus before it sets in the early evening. Actually, all 3 of these planets should be visible in the early evening throughout December. So get out there, junior scientists, and take a look up. You want meteor showers? Well, December's got them. Look up towards the constellation Gemini. The Geminid meteor shower will be taking place between December 4th and 20th, culminating on the night between December 13th and 14th, when you should be able to see 150 meteors an hour. Unlike most meteor showers, the Geminids originate from an asteroid and not from a comet. If you miss the Geminids, take a look up towards the Little Dipper. The Ursids will peak on the night between the 21st and the 22nd, with a less impressive, but by no means shabby, 10 meteors an hour. This month's full moon takes place on December 18th. December's full moon is called the cold moon for, well, pretty obvious reasons for those of us here in North America. Occasionally, it's called the Wolf Moon, and the old-timey Anglo-Saxon name for it is the Moon Before Yule. December 21st marks the start of winter for half of the Earth, during something that we call the Winter Solstice. Now, you've probably heard that term thrown around a lot, but what does it actually mean? We say that the Earth has an axis that it rotates about. It's like an imaginary line that joins the North and the South Poles. Every full rotation is one day, and that takes 24 hours. Now, this axis isn't perfectly perpendicular to the plane of our orbit around the sun. It's actually tipped at 23.5 degrees. The winter solstice marks the day that the North Pole is its furthest possible distance away from the sun. We experience our shortest day of the year in terms of daylight hours. It still takes 24 hours to do one full rotation. And in fact, the Arctic Circle experiences no daylight at all. Just 24 hours of darkness. After the 21st, the days start getting longer until we reach the summer solstice in June, when we tip the other way and bathe the northern hemisphere in the most sunlight that it gets all year. As we move deeper into the winter months, it'll get pretty cold. But when you're out there in your mitts and your jacket, just remember that it's not as cold as outer space, which on average is minus 270 degrees Celsius. That's so cold that if it got any colder, atoms would actually stop vibrating. Thanks for listening, and don't forget to have a science-tastic day. Special thanks to Royal City Science's own planetary geochemist, Dr. Glynis Perrett, for her help preparing our stargazing guide.